Hi, I'm Tatiana Benavides. With Tim and Kim, Bruno Klein, and Ryan Davis, we are part of the Integrated Analysis Team at the Agile BioFoundry. The Agile BioFoundry, or ABF, is a Department of Energy-sponsored collaboration program that investigates bio-based pathways to produce advantage products, including advanced biofuels, intermediate products, and bioproducts in general. And the goal is to enable biorefineries to achieve 50% reductions in time to bioprocess scale-up as compared to the current average of around 10 years. The integrated analysis team goal is to help quantify the economic and environmental sustainability potential for a given molecule, beachhead molecule, product pathway of interest. And we compare these different products or synthesis routes to understand the different merits and drawbacks and compare to the fossil-based derived pathways and highlight the key drivers for the techno-economic and life cycle analysis that help prioritize research and development. Here, I present the approach for the TEA and LCA. First, the conceptual process is formulated based on current research and expected chemical transformations. Individual unit operations are designed and modeled using experimental data. For example, the experimentalist will share with us the current titer rates and yields of the reactions or metabolic pathways. The process model outputs are used to size and cost the equipment. The capital and operating costs are input into an economic model, and this will help us to identify the major cost drivers. The material and energy inputs are inputs into our life cycle model, and we use the grid model to assess the emissions. And here we identify the major sustainability drivers. The key metrics for the techno-economic and life cycle analysis are minimum selling price and greenhouse gas emissions. We have other metrics in this techno-economic and life cycle analysis. All the results are provided back to our team, the ABF team, and they provide feedback to see what can we improve through the process modeling, changing titer rates and yields, or what are other major drivers that can be improved.
I'm Bruno Klein with Danrel. I will present an example on how TEA and LCA tools are being used in the consortium. The main goal of this task is to consider the full metabolic space of interest to ABF researchers and assess the production of bioproducts with fermentative pathways through several different routes. The ultimate goal is to understand the status of development of different molecules and to offer guidance to the experimental team on what parameters to prioritize in strain development. In short, several beachhead molecules, a concept that has already been presented in the Pathway Development and Evaluation webcast, are part of the metabolic pathways relevant to ABF efforts. However, since the possibilities stemming from a single beachhead molecule are many, carrying out a comprehensive sustainability assessment for all potential bioproducts is not a feasible option. Instead, the integrated analysis team focuses on selecting a single exemplar molecule to represent the metabolic space derived from each beachhead molecule of interest. So with this approach, we are able to restrict our assessment efforts to a single exemplar molecule per beachhead molecule of interest, which is chosen among a list of possible products by exploring similarities in terms of titer, rate and yield, of downstream commonalities and other parameters. The long-term goal is to perform this type of assessment for a large list of compound classes to understand how key fermentation parameters influence the economic and environmental performances of a biorefinery. As an example, the next few slides will present a brief case study for malic acid, a molecule currently produced from fossil sources at commercial scale, but that can also be obtained from biomass-based processes. In this particular effort, malic acid is obtained with the fermentation of mixed sugars using the yeast Lipomyces starkey and a metabolic pathway passing through pyruvate, the beachhead molecule in this case. We start by developing detailed process simulations of integrated biorefineries processing lignocellulosic biomass. There are multiple operations in these biorefineries, such as biomass pretreatment and hydrolysis, but the team focuses on variables pertaining to the aerobic fermentation portion of the process, which are decided upon in conjunction with other ABF researchers. The downstream processing is also tied to the bioproduct that we are getting from the fermentation step, and defining the right operations often requires connections with other DOE consortia. Building and running such process simulations is the first step to gather the required data to perform techno-economic and environmental assessments. In the economic assessment of such biorefineries, we often carry out a scan on the effect of varying productivity and product yield over the minimum selling price of a bioproduct. We then rely on 3D or contour plots, such as those presented here, to draw some conclusions. For malic acid specifically, we could infer that, for example, there is a stronger TA driver by way of productivity than product yield. There is a possibility of delivering malic acid to the market at prices that are competitive against the benchmark of $2 per kilogram for the fossil-based counterpart. And even for more aggressive fermentation conditions, the minimum selling price of malic acid can be found at values below $1 per kilogram.
Here I present the LCA results of malic acid. The GHG emissions are shown in the figure on the left, and the water consumption results are shown in the figure on the right. You can see that the GHG emissions and water consumption decrease as yield improves. Therefore, we notice that the yield is the dominant parameter determining the emissions and the water consumption. We noticed that there was insignificant impact on these metrics when the productivity was changing. At about 42% theoretical yield, the bio-based malic acid emits less GHG emissions than its fossil-based counterpart. And water consumption decreases for higher yields. However, it's still higher compared to its fossil-based derived malic acid. We have to note here that these biorefineries are not being optimized to minimize water. However, there are strategies to minimize the consumption of this processed water. Thank you for your attention, and here is our contact information for questions and suggestions.